A new leak claims Donald Trump abandoned the Iran nuclear deal to spite Barack Obama. British newspaper The Daily Mail has published more leaked memos from Kim Derrick, Britain's former ambassador in Washington. In them, Derrick wrote, Trump's wish to quit the deal was an act of diplomatic vandalism, seemingly for ideological and personality reasons. It was Obama's deal.
We have stopped the spread of nuclear weapons in this region.
The deal with the United States and other world powers was designed to stop Iran from building a nuclear weapon. And the leaked documents offer a window into Britain's efforts to save that agreement.
I don't think anybody has come up with a better idea.
The paper says the memo was written hours after Boris Johnson, then Britain's foreign secretary, returned from a trip to Washington last May, aimed at convincing the Americans to stick with the deal. But it didn't work.
I am announcing today that the United States will withdraw from the Iran nuclear deal.
Derrick wrote none of Trump's advisors had a plan B, nor could articulate why the president was determined to withdraw beyond his campaign promises. Derrick resigned last week after the first leaked memos were published, in which he trashed the Trump administration. And after Johnson, the favorite to become the UK's next prime minister, refused to defend the diplomat when he came under fire from the White House.
Police in the UK are hunting the culprits behind the leak. And the latest leak was published despite a police warning to journalists that doing so might be a crime. Yet Johnson and Jeremy Hunt, the two men battling to replace Theresa May as prime minister, have defended the media's right to publish.
It cannot conceivably be right that newspapers or any other media organization publishing such material should face prosecution.
The newspapers would publish that because they would make a judgment that was in the public interest. It's not for me to make that judgment, nor is it for me to second-guess the police. But what I will do is defend both the independence of the police and the independence of our press.